Hello everyone, so this is a lecture on the module classroom questions and solution of the chapter moving charge and magnetism. Okay, so you can see the first question on the screen where it says you have a magnetic field of induction, okay, at a point P. This should be off at a point P, at a point 5 cm from a long current carrying wire is given. Now what will be the field of induction at a distance 20 cm from the same wire? Okay. So, since it is saying long current carrying wire, so this is the case of Biot-Savart law, okay, long current, infinite long current carrying wire, the application of Biot-Savart law in case of infinite long current carrying wire. So, the relation was mu naught twice I by 4 pi A. This is what we covered in the theory, we covered it in this manner, okay. So, here, like in the first case the distance is 5 cm, the second case distance is 20 cm, therefore B is inversely proportional to A. Now since it is the same current carrying wire, so the current value is same, okay. So we are doing like second case by first case, B2 by B1 equal to A1 by A2. So 5 by 20, that gives you 1 by 4. Now you see B1 value is given in the question, which is 24 into 10 to the power minus 3. So 1 by 4 into 24 into 10 to the power minus 3. And the result is 6 into 10 to the power minus 3 Tesla. Okay, so option number B is the answer. Next question, number 2. So proton moving in a straight line enters a strong magnetic field along the field direction, okay. How will the path and velocity change? Well, you see it is along the field direction, that means it is parallel, right? And we know that when a charge particle moves parallel to a magnetic field, no magnetic force acts on the charge particle, therefore the path will remain the same, velocity will remain the same, okay. So which of the option is satisfying that? Path is same, velocity is same. Option number C is the answer, okay. Question number 3 next. You have a figure given, here a current is passing through this direction, okay. Now you have to find out the magnetic field at the center of these two semicircles. Now this first semicircle is of radius R1, second semicircle is of radius R2. Now we have a general relation for finding magnetic field due to an arc, right, which was mu naught I by 4 pi r into theta. In both the cases theta is same, alright. So you are finding out total magnetic field at the center, therefore in the first case the relation will become mu naught I divided by 4 pi r1 into pi, yes, into pi, plus second case mu naught I by 4 pi r2 into pi again. So this is your relation. Now pi pi cancels, it becomes mu naught I by 4, well I am taking mu naught I by 4 common, okay, 1 by r1 plus 1 by r2. So your relation is mu naught, final expression is mu naught I by 4 r1 plus r2 divided by r1 r2. Okay, option number C is the answer. Question number 4 next. Electron and a proton with equal momentum enter perpendicularly in a uniform magnetic field. Okay. So equal momentum, you see. The hint is equal momentum. Okay, electron, proton. What will happen to the path? Okay. So we know that radius relation is mv by qb. Now this is p by qb. P we can write for momentum. Now since momentum is constant and same magnetic field, all right, so you can say that r is inversely proportional to q. And here like electron, proton, they have same charge, yes, only positive and negative, but the charge is same, therefore they will have same, or you can say they'll have curves of same radius, okay. So which of the option is satisfying? You see, both are equally curved. Okay, but if I add one more thing here, if I show you the situation in diagram, this is additional. Okay, so you have this, they are entering perpendicularly. So you have the magnetic field perpendicular to the plane of this page. Okay, so in such a case, you have to apply Fleming's left hand rule. Okay, so electron, now Fleming's left hand rule, you have index finger, okay, towards the direction of magnetic field, which will be inwards. Middle finger will be direction of motion of the charge particle, which will be along upward. Index finger inward the page, and in that case thumb will show you the direction, or the thumb will show you the force acting on the positive charge. Therefore you will find that the positive charge is moving along this direction, the proton, and the negative charge is opposite to the positive charge. So the electron will move along this direction, but they'll have the same radius. So the question was actually asking you about the radius. So we are going with option number C, both are equally curved. But if direction is talked about, then you know, with the help of this diagram, you know what will be the directions. Okay, they will be different. Next question. Number 5. Proton and a deuteron and an alpha particle, they are accelerated through same potential difference. Through same potential difference, they enter the region of uniform magnetic field moving at right angles to V. What is the ratio of their kinetic energy? Now the relation for kinetic energy is QV. Yes, kinetic energy and voltage accelerating or potential difference is QV. So since Q is variable here and V is constant, same potential difference it is talked about. So Q is directly proportional to, K is directly proportional to Q since V is constant. Now if I write down like K1 is to K2 is to K3, the question is about ratio of kinetic energies. Charge of proton is E, charge of deuteron is E again, right? Deuteron is H2, one proton, one neutron in the nucleus. And charge of alpha particle is twice E. Therefore this becomes 1:2, 1:2, 2. Okay. Next, question number 6. Earth's magnetic field at a point is given. The field is to be annulled, okay, that means nullified, by magnetic induction at the center of a circular conducting loop of radius 5 cm. Okay. So the current required to be flown in the loop is nearly what? So you see, for a loop, Earth's magnetic field value is given as 0.5 × 10⁻⁵ Weber per meter square. Yes. Now B, for a circular loop, current at the center of the loop is given by mu naught I by 2 R. This was the relation. Now it is saying that the Earth's magnetic field should be nullified by this current due to a circular loop. Okay. Annulled by magnetic induction at the center of a circular loop. Alright. So by question you can write down that this B and BE is equal. Yes. And therefore we can write down mu naught. We can write down mu naught I by 2 R equal to BE. And I equal to, since you are asked to find out the value of current, so BE into 2 R divided by mu naught. So what is the value of BE given? 0.5 × 10⁻⁵. 2 R is 2 into radius 5 cm, which is 5 × 10⁻² in meter, SI unit, divided by 4 π × 10⁻⁷, value of mu naught. Okay. On calculation you will get 0.39 ampere, which is nearly 0.4 ampere, and this is option number B. Number 7. A ring of radius R is uniformly charged with charge Q. Okay. It is rotated with angular velocity omega. Then magnetic moment developed in the ring is what? Now you see, magnetic moment relation is current into cross section area of the ring, that is in this case. Now this current is caused by a charge q. Therefore current relation can be written as charge by time and area pi r square. Now you see, if you have to bring angular velocity here, okay, so what you have to do is, like, angular velocity relation is 2 pi nu, right, or 2 pi by t. So q into 2 pi r square divided by 2t, we can write 2 extra, right? Now this 2 pi by t is your angular velocity, yes, because angular velocity is omega equal to 2 pi nu, which is 2 pi by t. So you get q nu r square divided by 2, and that is your answer, option number A. Next, 8. A particle having charge q enters a magnetic field perpendicular to it. Which of the following is true? Now you see, energy is a scalar quantity, momentum is vector quantity, right? Now whenever a charge q enters a magnetic field perpendicular to it, the charge will have a circular path. Now that can be this way or this way also, depending on positive or negative charge. Therefore the direction is changing every moment, circular path, right? But energy will stay constant. So momentum will change and energy will stay constant. Therefore your answer is option number B. Okay, momentum, energy is scalar quantity, so energy stays same. It is distance, it is direction independent, and momentum is direction dependent. Therefore direction is changing and therefore momentum is changing, option number B. Question number 9. Next, galvanometer of resistance 10 ohm gives full scale deflection when 1 milliampere current passes through it. The resistance required to convert it into a voltmeter of voltmeter reading up to 2.5 volt is what? So you have to find out the value of the high resistance. Okay, you are converting a galvanometer into voltmeter. So the situation is like, you have this galvanometer, okay, and you are adding this high resistance in series. Okay, so 1 milliampere current is passing through the galvanometer. Okay, what is the resistance of the galvanometer? 10 ohm. Now you are converting it into a voltmeter. Therefore when it becomes a voltmeter, the voltage across will be 2.5 volt. You are finding out this R. What is the value of R? What is the relation? R equal to V by I minus G. So V value is 2.5, I value is 10 to the power minus 3, right, in SI, milliampere it is given, minus G value is 10. So this is giving you 2500 minus 10, which is 2490 ohm, option number A. 2490 ohm. Question number 10. Under the influence of uniform magnetic and field, a charged particle is moving in a circle of radius r with constant speed v. The time period of motion is what? So time period, what is the relation for time period? Time period relation is 2 pi m by qb, right? So it will depend on both r and v. It is independent of, here you see, it is depending on mass, it is depending on charge, it is depending on B, right? Magnetic field B. Time period is therefore, now for a particular charge, you see, for a particular charge, your mass is constant, charge is constant, and field is of course constant. That means it is independent of radius and velocity, option number C. Next, question number 11. A long straight wire carries current 10 ampere, okay, an electron travels perpendicular to this at a distance of 0.1 meter with the velocity of this. Force acting on the electron due to the current in the wire is what? So you have this wire, this is carrying 10 ampere DC current. Okay, an electron is say entering perpendicular, that means say, so we are representing it as cross. Okay, it is entering perpendicular to the page, and this distance is 0.1 meter. So of course F will be equal to, since velocity of electron is given, we can apply QVB sine 90, and it is already told that 90 perpendicular, therefore we are applying sine 90, and it is electron, right? So since it is electron, we'll put the charge of electron here. Well, QVB, well, what is the value of B? Now magnetic field due to this wire at this point will be mu naught I by 2 pi A, the relation which was like mu naught twice I by 4 pi A. Now we are writing it as mu naught I by 2 pi A. So charge value, you are finding out force, okay. The charge value is 1.6 10 to the power minus 19, 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19. Then you have mu naught. Okay, mu naught value charge. Then you have a speed. Okay, what is the value of a speed given? 5 into 10 to the power 6. Mu naught value is 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7, and current value is 10 divided by 2 pi. What is that? 10 to the power minus 1. This 0.1 meter is 10 to the power minus 1. On calculation, this will get you 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 17. Okay, option number C is the result. Next, you can see question number 12. So you have a straight wire of mass 200 gram and length 1.5 meter. This carries a current of 2 ampere. It is suspended in mid-air by a uniform horizontal magnetic field B. The magnitude of this magnetic field is what? Okay, so the situation is actually, you see, now you have the wire is now the concerned wire, and the question is say this. Okay, current is along this way. Now there is a reason why are we considering current in this direction. Magnetic field is along this way. Now if you apply Fleming's left hand rule here, like in Fleming's left hand rule, your middle finger should be towards the direction of current, right? And your index finger should be towards the direction of the magnetic field. So fix your index finger towards B and middle finger coming outside the page. Okay, this I is actually coming outside the page. Then the thumb will represent the F, magnetic force F, okay, which is acting upwards. Now the rod will have a weight mg, which is acting downwards. Okay, so the magnetic force is balanced by the weight mg, and for a rod of length L, our relation for magnetic field was BIL sin theta, but theta is the direction between length ILB, L and B, isn't it? L and B. So what is the direction, what is the angle between the length of the rod and the magnetic field B? Isn't it 90 degree? Okay, see, you see I is coming out perpendicular to the screen or to the plane. Therefore, we have sine 90 here, okay? And therefore, B will become what? Mg by IL. So, value of M is given in the question as 200 gram, which is 0.2 kg, into G value, take it as 10, I value 2, and length of the rod is given as 1.5. and this will get you 2/3, which is 0.66 Tesla, and this is option number D. Okay, next question, number 13. Now you have a long horizontal rigidly supported wire which is carrying a current of 96 ampere. Directly above it and parallel to it at a distance, another wire of 0.144 newton weight per meter carrying current 24 ampere in a direction opposite to that of the first wire. Now if the upper wire is floating in the air due to the magnetic repulsion from the first wire, then what is the distance? At what distance will you place the upper wire? So your situation is, the primary wire is this. This is fixed on a rigid support, okay? Say these ends are fixed. 96 ampere. The secondary wire is this. This is carrying current in a opposite direction, and therefore you know it well that they will repel each other. Yes. Now since the bottom, the primary wire is fixed, therefore this can stand due to the repulsion created by the primary wire. Okay. And here force per unit length value is given, 0.144 newton per meter. Okay. Now you have to find out this distance. Now we know that F by L, force per unit length, previously we wrote this relation as F, okay, but it was actually force per unit length only. So equal to mu naught by 4 pi 2 I A I B divided by D. You can check the relation in the force due to parallel wires. When they carry current in the same direction, the forces are attractive, and when they are in the opposite direction, the forces are repulsive. So here you are finding out D, right? So D is equal to mu naught by 4 pi 2 I A I B divided by F by L. So mu naught by 4 pi value is 10 to the power minus 7 into 2 into 24 into 96 divided by 144 into 10 to the power minus 3. So your answer will come out to be 32 into 10 to the power minus 4 meter, and this is 3.2 millimeter. Okay. So I am just considering the remaining questions in one more lecture.